The residents of New Bedford have used the harbor for recreational activities like fishing, swimming, and boating for generations. In the 20th century, local industry began using PCBs, or polychlorinated biphenyls, as industrial chemicals and insulating material in electrical equipment, and for most of the 20th century, PCBs were released directly into the harbor. As a result, the seafood in the harbor is contaminated. This contamination explains the many no fishing signs posted along New Bedford Harbor. One of EPA Superfund program's main goals is making the harbor fishable again by working to clean PCBs from the harbor's sediments over the next few years. Despite this progress, it is expected that fish caught in and near the harbor will remain contaminated well into the future. The group most vulnerable to this contamination are nursing mothers, pregnant women, women who may become pregnant, and children under the age of 12. EPA recommends that this group not eat fish, shellfish, or lobsters from anywhere in New Bedford Harbor. The only exception is that they are allowed to eat shellfish once a month from Clark's Cove and Area 3. New Bedford Harbor is divided into three fish closure areas. Familiar places like Fort Tabor Park and Sconticut Neck are in Area 2. Fort Phoenix State Park is in both Area 1, the part of the harbor north of the hurricane barrier, and in Area 2. The seafood advisory for Area 1. All seafood, including fish, shellfish, and lobsters caught inside the hurricane barrier, should not be eaten by anyone. There are no exceptions for Area 1. In Area 2, do not eat bottom feeding fish, including eel, flounder, scup, and tautog, or lobsters. Black sea bass, or shellfish, can be eaten no more than once a month from this area. Shellfish from Clark's Cove can be eaten once a week. In Area 3, do not eat scup or lobsters. Black sea bass, or tautog, can be eaten once a month from this area. There are no restrictions on eating shellfish. For any other fish species not mentioned by name, EPA has not gathered enough data to make a recommendation. EPA also recommends that anyone who wades or plays with their pets inside the hurricane barrier rinse themselves, their pets, and anything that comes into contact with the sediment with clean water immediately after the activity to avoid transfer of any PCB-contaminated sediment to vehicles and/or homes. New Bedford Harbor continues to be a major commercial fishing port as it has been for over a century. Fish and shellfish can be a healthy source of vital nutrients. For safety's sake, EPA recommends seafood purchased from a reputable local market served by commercial fishermen.